sorrowful and cloyed. यहाँ पे आप किसी के पीछे you pursue someone, you get that love, you satisfy the thirst, and that satisfaction does not give you kind of pleasure. It does not give you pleasure. In fact, it leaves a heart high, sorrowful and cloyed. आपको सब कुछ यहाँ पर मिलता है, but yet you are not satisfied. क्योंकि उसके बाद आपको और दुख मिलता है. High, sorrowful and cloyed. A burning forehead. और क्या मिलता है इस दुनिया में? A burning forehead and a parching tongue. Burning forehead, माथा झुलस, fever. We are talking of fever. And a parching tongue. Parching का मतलब होता है thirst, causing dryness. Parching का मतलब होता है causing dryness. आम्रा real life है जेटा पाई. What do we get? Real life में प्यार मिल जाता है. लेकिन ये प्यार जब मिलता है, after that particular episode of love making, it leaves us highly unsatisfied. जेटा आटेर जगते होते ना, because ওখানে তো কিস করার আগের মোমেন্টটাকে ইমর্টালাইজ করে দেওয়া হয়েছে. তাই সরো কাকে বলে, দুঃখ কাকে বলে, ডিসস্যাটিসফ্যাকশন কাকে বলে? দ্য লাভার ইজ নট অ্যাওয়ার অফ দ্যাট ইন দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ড অফ আর্ট. লেকিন রিয়েল লাইফ মে উই পিপল আর অ্যাওয়ার অফ হার্টেক্স, হার্ট ব্রেকস. ঠিক আছে, দৈবিকা মাঝে মাঝে খুব ভালো ভালো গালাগাল দিয়ে, জানি না কাকে দেয়, বাট দেয় ওখানে দেখি, অনেক বড় বড় কথা বলে. তো jai ho, coming back to this, that leaves a heart high, sorrowful and cloyed, a burning forehead and a parching tongue. Now, what we need to do is, we need to write down certain points regarding stanza number 2 and 3. If you remember, when we were going through with the first stanza, description do tarah se diye ja sakte hain. With the help of question marks. First stanza to sharakhun amra question mark I pelam, but with the help of those question marks we could actually make out what's there in the painting on the urn. Theek hai, with the help of question marks. But in stanza 2 and 3 we do not have question marks. In fact, here the poet explains the painting with the means of description. These are all descriptions, these are not questions. So in the first stanza, he was trying to establish the painting with the help of question marks. In the second and the third stanza, he is doing that with the help of description. He is describing things. He is not asking questions. He is describing it. So the first point that will be written, that has to be written down, is the second scene is presented by means of description. The second scene is presented by means of description. This is the first point. Point number 2. According to Keats, art gives a kind of permanence to reality. Art gives a kind of permanence to reality. Art gives a kind of permanence to reality. Point number 3. The youth, comma, the maiden and the instrument, the youth, the maiden and the instrument are held permanently by being pictured on the urn,
point number 4, I suppose.
Last point for this particular stanza.
Art arrests, ARRESTS, art arrests desirable experience Art arrests desirable experience. Mane, the lover was trying to kiss the beloved, but what does the art do? Art actually arrests desirable experience. Art does not want the lover to kiss the beloved. So it is arresting that particular moment. So art arrests desirable experience at a point before it can become undesirable. Before it can become undesirable. Before it can become undesirable. माने जब तक उसको नहीं मिल रहा है, he is pursuing the beloved. हो सकता है कि एक बार उसको जब वो मिल जाए तो हो सकता है उसको और वो पसंद ही ना आए, जैसा यूजुअली प्यार में होता है. दिस इज़ वॉट यूजुअली हैपन्स इन लव, कि द टाइम द मोमेंट वेन यू आर परसुइंग देर इज़ लॉट ऑफ लव. वंस यू अचीव दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग, यू थिंक अरे इट्स समथिंग एवरी डे थिंग्स हैपन, सो वॉट, आई डोंट नॉट डिज़ायर हर अनडिज़ायरेबली. दिस इज़ द सेम फॉर बॉयज़ एंड गर्ल्स, बाय द वे. कमिंग बैक टू दिस, आर्ट अरेस्ट्स डिज़ायरेबल एक्सपीरियंस एट अ पॉइंट बिफोर इट कैन बिकम अनडिज़ायरेबल, फुल स्टॉप. दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू कीट्स, दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू कीट्स, दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू कीट्स, दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू कीट्स वन ऑफ द प्लेजरेबल कंट्रीब्यूशन, वन ऑफ द प्लेजरेबल कंट्रीब्यूशन. दिस इज अकॉर्डिंग टू कीट्स वन ऑफ द प्लेजरेबल contributions, one of the pleasurable contributions of art to man, one of the pleasurable contributions of art to man, one of the pleasurable contributions of art to man. So what we did today was, as I told you earlier, ki on this particular Grecian urn, an imagined Grecian urn, there are three scenes depicted. We have gone through the two scenes. Theek hai? The last scene, that means the last two stanzas, will be dealt with in the next class. So hopefully, I hope that you have understood this particular lesson on Grecian urn, ode on a Grecian urn. In fact, we need to discuss in length what is the definition of an ode. That is for the later class. We will take up that particular issue also, about the form and thing, the form and structure of this particular poem also. We will get enough time for that in the second class that we have. So if you have any questions regarding this particular section that we have just completed, you can either personally WhatsApp me the question, I can tell you, I can give you the answer to this particular thing, or you can post a comment down below in the YouTube comment section, so that I can come back to you later when I see those questions. Okay, so for now, I bid you adieu, a goodbye. Stay at home, be safe from corona, and do help people out there in your locality. Do provide them with foods as well as animals too, because they are also suffering. So do provide food. Rather than providing donation, please do provide food for the needy and the helpful. So with this, a goodbye. We'll meet again in our next class.